It wasn't until I moved to Monterey that I really started experiencing being in the ocean in a real way. Being able to spend time in the water is just one of the most magnificent experiences of my life. I'm Jessie Johnson, and I'm a photographer and camera assistant. We have been filming otters, elephant seals, nudibranchs, and all the other animal life within the sanctuary. We had the most wonderful opportunity to spend 3 entire months following the southern sea otters. The relationship between southern sea otters and their pup is truly a remarkable one to watch. As soon as mating is complete, the male moves on and continues to mate with other females, but the female is left to raise her young on her own. And so when you see these females, they're really single moms trying to make it work. Many of the otters' first pups don't survive because they're trying to figure out how to be successful mothers. And when you're watching these otters, and you know, because of the cold waters that we live in, it's important that they keep their pups out of the water as much as possible. They have to trust the environment that they live in, that until the pup starts diving, they have to leave the pup at the surface of the water while they dive to feed, and they have to do that many times a day. It's pretty touching to see how trusting these mothers are with the environments that they live in, and also the huge personal sacrifices they're making to raise their pups. Another behavior that we saw between the moms and pups that was so fascinating to us is they raise them almost in a nursery-like setting. Sometimes we'll find huge rafts of moms and pups in beds of sea kelp, and the moms will be kind of dealing with rough housing pups in the afternoons, and you can almost see it on the mom's faces, just like you can see it on a human's mom's face. It's like, oh, I'm just worn out, can you just calm down, I just want to take a rest. Their pups are wrestling and playing, and the moms are trying so hard to just keep them alive. One of the things that we saw a lot of is human interaction with the otters. People love the otters. They're one of the reasons that people come to visit our bay. Unfortunately, they love them a little too closely sometimes. And when kayakers or other people using the water get too close to sleeping otters, the otters have to flush into the water and move to another place. By all means, come in and see the otters. But once you're in the water, there's a few simple techniques to protecting the otters. And primarily that's staying back a certain distance so that you're not eliciting a response from them in any way. When I was 10 years old, I started learning about how our entire world's ecosystem is developed. And what I learned is that the ocean is the lungs of our world. And so when you're thinking about this little southern sea otter that only lives in certain locations, you may wonder why it's important to care about this animal. And the reason is because they are an indicator of the health of our system at large. And if any part of that system breaks down, we will all suffer. Not only people that live in Monterey Bay will suffer if the oceans change or become polluted or become toxic, it will also impact people that live in the mountains and in the deserts and worldwide.